The Commerce Department is looking at ways to better develop its database ahead of the 2020 census. One America's Alex Salvi has more on the hurdles they face and the changes you can expect to see.
To some, the federal census is nothing more than numbers, but it actually decides everything from how much money your community gets to how many lawmakers you send to Congress. The clock is ticking for the Census Bureau to hand over its final list of questions that every household in the U.S. will have to complete for the 2020 count.
The 2020 decennial census is the department's top priority.
Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross says his department will add a question to the census, asking people to state their citizenship. The Justice Department wanted to bring the question back for the first time since 1950. In hopes of improving statistical information.
We are responding solely to the Department of Justice's request, not to any campaign request, not to any other political party request.
But many Democrats oppose the measure, saying it would harm the Bureau's ability to get an accurate count since non-citizens will be hesitant to participate.
But I don't think the census should be used to create more division, more fear, more hiding from people who should be forward and being counted.
The finalized list of questions for the 2020 form is the first major initiative. The second is a dress rehearsal for a new technology-driven system, with Providence County, Rhode Island being this year's test subject.
We want to ensure that every single Rhode Islander is counted in the census 2 years from now.
Households in Providence have been able to respond to the 2018 census online. And on April 9th, the questionnaires will be distributed to be filled out over the web.
Everyone in Providence County is going to get what I just got in the mail, which is this form. You're going to get either questions with it or advice to go online.
The Commerce Department says the 2020 census could cost around $15 billion, but the most recent spending bill only allocated $4 billion for the Census Bureau for this year. In order to cut down costs, there will be fewer people knocking on doors and more data taken from local governments and postal services.
They're using government administrative records in new ways, the census, to reduce the workload of going out and collecting information from those that don't self-respond.
Some people can still expect to get a knock on the door, but will have an easier time responding on electronics rather than mailing in a form.
The big thing that the Census Bureau is doing is using automation and handheld devices to collect the information from those that don't self-respond.
The census has remained nearly the same since the 1970s. But with new technology, the Census Bureau predicts it will save nearly $5 billion compared to the last decennial count 8 years ago. Alex Salvi, One America News.
We can use your help. Call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call today,